And that sacrifice of the seed of the Son, in my opinion, this is not what the Quran is saying, this is my view, is now taking place in the sacrifice of the Arabs.
Now, moving to your book, Methodology for Study of the Quran, you mentioned about certain examples of ayat mutashabihat, and one of it was the sacrifice of Nabi Ismail alayhi salam, mentioned in Surah As-Saffat. Could you relate to us that interpretation, which is
the Quran has never said that the child of the sacrifice was Nabi Ishaq. Never. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has no shortage of vocabulary. If he wanted to say that the child of the sacrifice was Nabi Ishaq, or that the child of the sacrifice was Nabi Ismail alayhim as-salam, he could have said so, but he never said so. It is in the hadith that you will find that the child of the sacrifice is Nabi Ismail alayhi salam. Now then, what I did say is that without identifying the child of the sacrifice, that when Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam had the vision, and then he went to his son and he said to his son, surely I have seen myself sacrificing you in a dream, in my sleep, sorry. What is your response? My response to this is that Allah has never required human sacrifice in anything in the religion of Islam. And as a consequence, this cannot be understood as an ayah muhkama. When Ibrahim alayhi salam took the knife and was about to sacrifice his son, understanding the verse to be ayah muhkama, then Allah stopped him and said, Qad sadaqta ru'ya, you have already fulfilled the vision, even though you have not literally sacrificed your son, because this is not ayah muhkama, this is ayah mutashabihat. What Allah wanted from you was to accept in your heart the sacrifice of the seed of the Son. And that sacrifice of the seed of the Son, in my opinion, this is not what the Quran is saying, this is my view, is now taking place in the sacrifice of the Arabs.